हेलो एंड वेलकम टू रेडियो सिटी इंडिया यूट्यूब चैनल। और एशिया कप तो अभी खत्म हो चुका है, पर एशिया कप का थोड़ा सा रिव्यू करना बनता है। तो हमारे साथ स्टूडियो में आज फिर एक बार मौजूद है आशुतोष भाईभले जी। नमस्कार, आपका स्टूडियो में फिर से स्वागत है, क्योंकि इंडिया जीत गई है इस बार।
धन्यवाद। इंडिया जीती, लेकिन बांग्लादेश ने भी उम्दा परफॉर्मेंस दिया।
आपने उनको सपोर्ट करने के लिए ग्रीन?
उनको सपोर्ट नहीं, सपोर्ट तो हमेशा इंडिया ही रहा है, पर रिस्पेक्ट के लिए इंसिडेंटली आज उनका कलर आ गया।
ओके, तो मैंने तो ब्लैक पहना है, पता नहीं मैं किसको रिस्पेक्ट कर रहा हूँ आज। मे बी इट्स फॉर न्यूजीलैंड, दो दे आर नॉट प्लेइंग अ मैच। सो वील डिस्कस ऑल द टीम्स व्हिच हैव प्लेड एशिया कप। सो पहले हम स्टार्ट करेंगे, जो टीम पहले सबसे बाहर हुई है दैट इज श्रीलंका।
परफेक्ट, मुझे लगा आप हांगकांग की बात करेंगे।
नहीं, हांगकांग से बुरा श्रीलंका खेली है इस बार, तो श्रीलंका के बारे में बात।
श्रीलंका और उनका बेस्ट प्लेयर था एंजेलो मैथ्यूज, उन्होंने उनको भी कैप्टनसी से निकाल दिया, कैप्टनसी के टीम से भी बाहर निकाल दिया।
हाँ।
तो अभी श्रीलंका के लिए गोइंग फॉरवर्ड भी क्या सोच रहे उनके बोर्ड को ही पता है। उन्होंने चांदीमल को कैप्टन बनाया है अभी, जो खुद एक लिमिटेड ओवर्स फॉर्मेट में उनकी प्लेस ही गारंटीड नहीं। तो एक ही ब्राइट स्पॉट पूरे उनके टूर्नामेंट में रहा, वो है मलिंगा का री इमर्जेंस। तो वो एक ही ब्राइट स्पॉट है, बाकी तो बैटिंग ऑर्डर भी कुछ भी करते हैं। कुशल परेरा से ओपन कराना चाहिए, वो कुशल परेरा को नीचे रखते हैं। कुशल मेंडिस, जिनका सक्सेस नंबर 3 पे रहा है, उनको वो ओपन कराते हैं। उनके बेस्ट बैट्समैन एंजेलो मैथ्यूज थे, ही शुड बी बैटिंग एट 4, बट धनंजय डिसिल्वा कम्स इन अहेड ऑफ हिम, हु इज मोर ऑफ अ फिनिशर। सो बैटिंग ऑर्डर, टीम सिलेक्शन, एवरीथिंग नीड्स टू बी अंडर स्क्रूटिनी। बट आई फील रिमूविंग मैथ्यूज एंड not just from the captain, from the team as well, is a step in the backward direction. He is their best player without doubt. You should trust him.
But I think Sri Lanka is going back to Mahendra Jayawardene and Kumar Sangakkara, because they are playing much better even at this
age. Incidentally, Dilshan said that he might consider coming out of retirement.
So, अभी ये हाल है कि श्रीलंका के पुराने जो retired players हैं, वो शायद return आने के सोच रहे हैं. So, second team we'll discuss is Hong Kong.
Hong Kong were the not surprise. Favorites for the cup, for entering in the main draw. UAE were the favorites, team composition wise, plus home team. So UAE were the number one favorites. Number two, I would say, would be close between Hong Kong and Nepal. Obviously, Hong Kong are a little ahead of Nepal, but Hong Kong surprised them, UAE, and made it to the main draw. In the group stage also, the only match which India had it tough, I mean obviously the final was tough as well, before the final, the only match which India had it tough was against Hong Kong. So lots of positives for Hong Kong. Their captain Anshuman Rath, the other opener Nizakat Khan, their one down batsman is a well known player, he plays franchise cricket as well, Babar Hayat. So lot of positives for them. So I'm sure they will they can emerge as the next Afghanistan in a period of say 5 years.
But the problem is that most of the players retire at the age of around 23-24, when it's like the peak season. And this is what one interview I read of the coach. So he was like, Hong Kong is a very expensive place to leaving. So usually people leave cricket and go into their other career fields. Even what happened with the earlier captain Atkinson, so he went to be a teacher now. So this is something which
that is where bringing. Maybe the role of ICC or the Hong Kong Cricket Council should come in, wherein they should come up with a proper cricketing professional platform for them, wherein their basic needs are taken care of, and only then can a person perform for his national team.
Okay, so the next team which we talk about is maybe Pakistan.
Yes. Pakistan came into the Asia Cup as second favorites, just close behind India. And what was their strength was their bowling. And surprisingly, they started out with 5 main bowlers, being Fahim Ashraf, Shadab Khan, Hasan Ali, Mohammad Amir and Usman Khan Chinwari. These were the 5 who played in the first match against India. Over a period of time, everyone is coming in and going out. Shehnshah Afridi came in, Junaid Khan came in, Mohammad Nawaz came in. So that speaks that they don't have a settled lineup. So the bowling, which was supposed to be their strength, had to go through so many changes.
Even Mohammad Amir, who was their mainstay kind of in bowling, even he flopped.
Absolutely.
So, and that too badly.
And now, but they are ringing in the changes. They need players like Wahab Riaz.
Yeah.
So hopefully, I'm sure, and hopefully Imad Wasim is, I think he was not fit for the Asia Cup. Hopefully he'll be fit. So they'll get that second spinner in Imad Wasim, who can bat a bit. The biggest success or biggest find of Asia Cup for Pakistan has been Imam Ul-Haq.
Yeah, yeah. Thodi thodi jhalki aa gayi thi Imam ki. Taza ho gaye unke uncle hai.
थोड़ा उनकी स्टाइल अगर आप देखें थोड़े मुझे वो ग्रेम स्मिथ जैसे लगते हैं. लेफ्टी है, थोड़ा हाई बैक लिफ्ट है, ग्राफ्ट करते हैं, तो थोड़े मुझे वो ग्रेम स्मिथ जैसे लगते हैं. भले रिश्तेदार इंतजाम के, तो उन्होंने दो तीन चेज में अपना कूल दिखाया, कूल अप्रोच दिखाया, तो मुझे वो उनके बिगेस्ट प्लस पॉइंट लगे पूरे टूर्नामेंट.
ओके, सो व्हाट डू यू हैव टू से अबाउट द कैप्टेंसी सरफराज?
मैंने पहले भी बोला है, मुझे सरफराज की कैप्टन समाओ
प्रेशर में आए होंगे अभी.
नहीं, एक तो बैड टूर्नामेंट से जनरली अच्छे प्लेयर उससे इमर्ज आउट होते हैं, सो आई एम श्योर ही विल बाउंस बैक.
या सो नेक्स्ट टीम दैट वी टॉक अबाउट इज अफगानिस्तान.
अफगानिस्तान हैव बीन द फाइंड ऑफ द एशिया. दे इन द ग्रुप स्टेज दे डिफीटेड बोथ श्रीलंका एज वेल एज बांग्लादेश. इन द सुपर फोर समहाउ दे लॉस्ट क्लोज गेम्स. Every match went into the last over. Two matches they lost in the last over. One match they ended in a tie. So, they can only get better from this position. And what was the best plus point for them was the batting. Who would have thought that their batsmen would give their bowlers a platform around 250 every match consistently. The best part is, कोई ना कोई हर बार स्टेप अप कर लेता. कभी मोहम्मद शहजाद खेल लिए, कभी हशमतुल्ला शाहिदी खेल लिए, कभी उनके कैप्टन असगर अफगान खेल लिए, कभी रहमत शाह उनके बेस्ट बैट्समैन खेल लिए. तो कोई ना कोई खेलता है 250 तक पहुंचा था. तो जो उनका वीक पॉइंट था उनका बैटिंग, पर उनकी बैटिंग बहुत अच्छी रही, सो दैट इज द बिगेस्ट प्लस पॉइंट फॉर देम.
ओके, और शायद अफगानिस्तान इज द ओनली टीम व्हिच हैज स्कोर्ड अराउंड 250 इन एवरी मैच. Except India, that is. So, what do you have to say about the bowling, which has always been the strength?
The reason we didn't mention Rashid Khan and company because they have always been good. Yeah. So, and they have consistently been doing well. But the fast bowling somehow thoda sa better hona chahiye. Maybe they missed an extra spinner in the squad. Maybe a Zaheer Khan or a Qais Ahmed in the squad, and maybe playing him a game would have helped, because. Somehow, Aftab Alam and Gulbuddin Naib together, 20 overs is a bit of too much to ask from them. So, and especially we have a spinner, Mujibur Rahman, who bowls with the new ball. So, you don't need only one fast bowler maybe. But, okay. All in all, positive for Afghanistan.
Okay, so then the next team is Bangladesh, the runner-ups of the Asia Cup.
Super positive with Bangladesh.
Again.
I mean, what Bangladesh was about 5 years back, we see Afghanistan doing that role. And Bangladesh has emerged out of it as well. So they have gone one level higher and doing well as well. If you see the last few matches which India has had with Bangladesh, every match has been close. This Asia Cup final, before that the Nidhi Haas Trophy final, before that World T20, wherein Hardik Pandya took two wickets. So it has been, every time Bangladesh has been getting very close. Somehow they have been unlucky losing out to India on most occasions. So, and the biggest positive is that they played without Tamim Iqbal for majority of the tournament and Shakib Al Hasan for the last two crucial games. So, and the kind of impact these two players have is without doubt very crucial. So these two, along with Mushfiqur Rahim and Mustafizur Rahman, were the core of the Bangla team. So, चार में से दो मिसिंग, तो बहुत गैप्स फिल करने थे, बट दे डिड वेल इवन इन द फाइनल. तो पहले तो स्टार्ट लिटन दास ने जो दिया, आई हैड सीन लिटन दास इन द मैच अगेंस्ट वेस्ट इंडीज इन द T20. ही वाज प्लेइंग वेरी वेल, सो ही ऑलवेज हैड दैट टैलेंट, बट ही वाज नेवर एबल टू स्केल इट अप इन द ODI फॉर्मेट एंड हाई प्रेशर फाइनल अगेंस्ट अ क्वालिटी ऑपोजिशन विद अ ब्रिलियंट अटैक. So he did very well. Somehow Bangla didn't capitalize on the start, I believe. So 220 was not a good track, a score on that track. Par bowling.
Mustafizur Rahman jo angle create karte hain,
wahi angle, wahi position, wahi cutter, aur their sare wickets.
Match after match, he's just bowling there, getting the wickets there, and it has been like
even a, against Afghanistan, उन्होंने तो 8 run defend करके दिखाया.
Yeah.
तो last over में 8 run defend करना यानी बहुत मुश्किल काम है. So hats off to Bangladesh. They can also only get better from here.
Okay.
And biggest plus point has been Litton Das emerging. Obviously, Mushfiqur Rahim played well, but I mean, you don't mention him because he's known, he's been there,
he's
done
been
that.
Legend, right?
Yeah, he's
Bangladesh.
So biggest plus point has been Litton Das.
Okay. So now the big team, the winners of Asia Cup, that is India.
India came into the tournament without Virat Kohli. In the first game, Hardik Pandya got injured, so the crucial all-rounder slot became empty. So in spite of that, India won the Asia Cup, but still a few questions going into the 2019 World Cup. I mean, it is there in everyone's mind, I'm sure.
Yes, MS Dhoni.
MS Dhoni is one, but the crucial middle order.
Yeah.
I'll tell you a strange statistics. India scores, the Indian top three scores around 60% of all runs, which is highest, and England's top three being second. So around 60-65%, both these teams score. So it is not that the pressure is there on the middle order every time. More of one out of three times, they have to bat. So that is crucial, because if we lose out on two or three wickets early.
Yeah.
So how do we go about that? So 1-2-3 is settled with Virat Kohli coming back in. 4, 5, and 6. Six, Kedar Jadhav would have been, I would have said that he's a very good spinning all-rounder. I like the combination of one spinning all-rounder, one fast bowling all-rounder. So with Hardik Pandya at 7, Kedar Jadhav at 6 would have been perfect, but he's injury prone.
Yeah.
So we have to think beyond Kedar Jadhav as well. What names come to mind?
Ravindra Jadeja.
Cannot bat at 6. I mean, even at 7, I'll say, I will still prefer maybe a Krunal Pandya. Krunal Pandya can bowl 10 overs, can bat as well.
Yeah.
So Krunal Pandya, I believe, might just be a little better than Ravindra Jadeja. So that is one name we have to consider. Other than that, maybe we really don't have many options to think of. Now coming to number 5. MS Dhoni. MS Dhoni started having his bad patch around, say, 2015 onwards, wherein he wasn't the Dhoni of the earlier times, like wherein he was finishing matches. When he started having a bad patch, everybody thought it was just a passing phase. And most importantly, when you see a player, you need to see other alternatives in that position as well.
Yeah.
So 2015-16 mein Dhoni ke koi alternative nahi thi. Par 2018 ho gaya. Bad patch continue ho raha hai. Secondly, Dinesh Karthik 2.2 emerge ho rahe hain. Rishabh Pant emerge ho rahe hain. To Dhoni ki jagah pe continuous scrutiny rahegi. And if you don't finish the match in a 220 odd chase, then automatically you will be always under the scrutiny.
Yeah.
So Dhoni has to step up now. We don't have too much time left.
Yeah.
And it is not the Dhoni of old. Time and again, somehow wo finishing nahi raha.
Okay. And even with Raidu and Manish Pandey knocking the doors in every single match.
If you would have asked me before the Asia Cup, I would have wanted Rahul at 3. I still prefer Rahul at 3, but Virat Kohli is not ready to come down to 4.
Yeah.
In ODI. In T20s, Rahul bats at 3 and Virat Kohli bats at 4.
Yeah.
So Indian 1-2-3 is settled. Virat Kohli is not going to go down at 4. So Virat Kohli is going to bat at 3. So at number 4, I prefer Dinesh Karthik or Manish Pandey over even Raidu.
Okay.
Even Rahul over Raidu, I believe. Obviously, Raidu has had a decent Asia Cup.
But his still, age is not on his side right
fielding
now.
Also. I mean, I still prefer these two. Manish Pandey is a gun of a fielder. And Dinesh Karthik 2.2 has really... I mean, he hasn't got those many chances. He's been very unlucky. So, for the number 4 and 5 positions, we have Rahul, Dinesh Karthik, Manish Pandey and Rishabh Pant, who can give Dhoni and one of these run for their money.
So this was the review of the Asia Cup. So now we'll come down to the main thing. Asia Cup ka 11 aapke hisab se kaun hona chahiye?
Without doubt, the openers will be Shikhar Dhawan, Rohit Sharma.
Yeah.
Number three would be pretty close, but after a review, I believe Hashmatullah Shahidi. Raidu also scored runs, but coming in after Rohit Sharma and Dhawan, pressure is always less. Plus, backed by a superb Indian bowling, so you're always chasing less. So I'll go with Hashmatullah Shahidi at number three.
Okay.
The Afghanistan player. So number four would be Mushfiqur Rahim, who also would be the wicketkeeper batsman. Number five would be Shoaib Malik, the only Pakistani player in my 11. He played well, without doubt, finished matches as well. So number five would be Shoaib Malik. So since you're mentioning Shoaib Malik, let's ask an interesting trivia to our viewers.
Yeah,
Shoaib Malik is among the only three players who has had a debut before 2000 and is still playing. So you have to guess the other two. We'll be telling you those two at the end of the video.
Okay, so start commenting.
Okay. Yes. So, the coming back to the number 6 and 7. I always prefer all-rounders at 6 and 7. Ideally, a fast-bowling all-rounder and a spinning all-rounder. We didn't have too many choices with fast-bowling all-rounders. So, it has to be more so spinning. So, without doubt, Mohammad Nabi makes a position at 6 or 7. Mohammad Nabi. The other position, the contenders were Jadeja, Kedar Jadhav, and Thisara Pereira. Thisara Pereira played only 2 matches. But played very well in those 2 matches. It was unfortunate his team went out. But he was a contender. But still, I'll go with Kedar Jadhav because I like his batting. You want your number 6 to be a very good batsman. And Nabi can fill in 10 overs easily. So, Kedar Jadhav at 6, Mohammad Nabi at 7. Now it comes to the 4 bowlers. 3 bowlers tied with respect to top wicket takers. And not just because they have tied with respect to top wicket takers, their strike rate was good, their economy rate was less, their average was good, and the impact which they had overall was way better than the others. So these three straight away make it to the 11. Who are these three?
Rashid Khan. Jasfir Bumrah.
Jasfir Bumrah is not among the highest wicket taker. Mustafizur Rahman and Kuldeep Yadav. So these three make it, and the 11th position has to be Jasprit Bumrah. So, 2 fast bowlers and 2 wrist spinners. And we have a left arm fast as well. And we have a right arm fast as well. Bumrah. So, who incidentally wasn't there among the top wicket takers only because he played 2 games less. He was rested.
So, this was the 11. What do you think? Aapke top 11 mein kaun aayenge? Neeche comment section mein likhiye. By the way, we are getting a lot of comments from Bangladesh for the final match which we did last week, and thank you for commenting. Please, aap isme bhi comment kijiye. What do you think? Whom do you want in your 11? Whom do you don't want in the 11? Jo bhi hai aapke man mein, please likhiye niche aur hume bataiye. Hum jo next video karenge, usme hum zarur iske bare mein baat karenge. So this was the video, guys. So if you like the video, please thumbs up, like kariye, share kijiye apne doston ke sath, अपने फैमिली के साथ, जो क्रिकेट को समझते हैं, जिनको क्रिकेट से इंटरेस्ट रखते हैं, उनसे आप शेयर कर सकते हैं. और सबसे बड़ी बात, सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलिए रेडियो सिटी इंडिया के यूट्यूब चैनल को. तो हम अभी लेते हैं विदा. हम आपको फिर एक बार मिलेंगे इंडिया वर्सेस वेस्ट इंडीज का जो टेस्ट मैच स्टार्ट होने वाला है उसका प्री मैच एनालिसिस लेकर. सो तब तक के लिए देखते रहिए रेडियो सिटी इंडिया का यूट्यूब चैनल. और जाने से पहले बड़ी बात, आपने जो क्वेश्चन पूछा था उसका आंसर आपने अब तक नहीं दिया.
बता देते हैं यूएस को कि 2 प्लेयर है जो अभी भी खेल रहे हैं अलोंग विद शोएब मलिक, जिनका डेब्यू 2000 के पहले हुआ है. एक है क्रिस गेल और दूसरे है रंगना हीरा. और अगर अपन एक साल पीछे गए 2017 नवंबर तक, एक और प्लेयर थे, इंसिडेंटली बता रहा हूँ, वो इंडियन थे, आशीष नेहरा.
ओके, सो ये ट्रिविया आपको मिल गया. ये आप नोट करके रख लीजिए, अपने फ्रेंड्स को इंप्रेस कर सकते हैं आप इसके साथ. सो वी आर टेकिंग विदा फ्रॉम यू. दिस इज हैंसन एंड आशुतोष सेइंग गुड बाय. बाय बाय.
चलो.